Hello, Odooers, and welcome back. There is a key element we shouldn't overlook in Stealthy Wood's manufacturing process, the overall equipment effectiveness, also known as OEE. OEE is the gold standard for measuring a company's manufacturing productivity. But why do we use OEE in a small to medium enterprise like Stealthy Wood? The reason is simple. OEE helps us identify the percentage of truly productive manufacturing time across my work centers. Identifying productivity losses helps me pinpoint areas for improvement, making operations more efficient and cost-effective. OEE can lead to a significant return on investment, especially when we launch a new product. After all, making sure that existing equipment is being used efficiently reduces the amount of money we need to spend to meet our production needs. Keeping an eye on the overall equipment effectiveness is vital for when trying to reach a company's true potential. So let's see how we can take advantage of it in Odoo. At first, OEE might seem difficult to understand and compute. Luckily, Odoo calculates and records these values automatically. That means that the complicated steps are taken care of in the background while the regular production operations continue like normal. This is very convenient since not everyone is an expert in manufacturing. So let's hop into the manufacturing application where I have a dashboard overview of my work centers. As you can see, there's an OEE field with a percentage for each of my active work centers. Right now, the OEE percentage for each work center is in green, which indicates that the work centers are meeting their targets. If the OEE drops below the target, then the number will turn red. For example, I can change the OEE target for this work center to be greater than its current OEE by clicking on the three dots on the top right and clicking on Settings. Under Product Information in the OEE target field, let's change it to 100. Let's see what happens when I go back to the dashboard via the breadcrumbs. And now the percentage is red, since my team didn't reach the OEE target that I set. But let's cut my team some slack, since we don't expect the work center to operate at 100% efficiency. So let's change it back to 90. I can learn more about my work center's production statistics when I click on the work center's OEE button. This helps me identify factors that are affecting the work center's effectiveness. For example, we can see that this work center, Drill Station 1, has been doing really well with its fully productive time, with just a small portion of the total time being taken up by reduced speed. If I want to access an overall OEE report for all of my work centers, I can go to the reporting subheading at the top and click on Overall Equipment Effectiveness. By default, this view is grouped by work center and loss reason. I can even remove some of the sections from view. This is a great method for visually gauging efficiency. For example, let's click on the fully productive time at the top of the graph. To further understand OEE and how it's computed, let's see how it changes when it takes longer than expected to manufacture a product. I'll start by opening an MO for a wood panel that's already confirmed. So let's go to the operations subheading and click on manufacturing orders and select the wood panel MO. Then I'll go to the work orders tab and in the drill operation in the real duration field, let's change it to 80. That's 20 minutes longer than the expected duration of 60 minutes, which was set on the operations tab in the wood panel's bill of materials. Okay. Let's head back to the manufacturing dashboard by clicking on the overview menu at the top. And would you look at that, Odooers? Odoo has automatically calculated a new OEE, which has been instantly impacted from 95% to 93%. When I click on the OEE link, I can see that the work center's fully productive time has decreased by just a smidge due to an increase in the reduced speed. If I click on the reduced speed pie chart segment, I'm shown a list of every time the loss reason occurred. If I want, I also have the option to manually create and report a loss reason. So let's go ahead and click New. Let's say I experienced a material availability issue that wasn't immediately reflected on the work order. So in the loss reason field, let's select material availability. As promised, everything related to the OEE calculation is automatically handled by Odoo based on the actions that the employees record during the manufacturing process. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.